Don't forget to turn your dues again. Here's an international society.
Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live and Five Show, where we are living live. I'm Jimmy Tang.
I'm Alexis Nunquist. Are you ready to step up your game in the TriStar basketball?
And everyone gets punished for having bad grades, but we have a story that's way worse than the usual.
How did our test all choices do against the Whitney Wildcat?
All of this and much more.
Before it goes away.
No prompting.
They look good.
You get this Slim Jim, then you get this Chewy Bar, and this Rice Krispies Treat, the Strawberry Rice Krispies Treat, and this Brown Sugar Pop-Tart, and this Ice Cream Chappé Pop-Tart, and this Cookies and Cream Pop-Tart, and this Umbrella, and this DVD Brown, and this Flash Drive, and this Pocket Food.
Welcome back, and now to the news.
Today's the TriStar Basketball Contest. It's a chance for you to show off your skills in shooting hoops, dribbling for time, and passing with accuracy. It's free, and you can win a trophy. The best part is that it's here at Tetzloff. It's here at Tetzloff today during lunch on the basketball courts.
There's an international society meeting at lunch in room 307. Don't forget to turn in your dues. Again, today's an international society meeting at lunch in room 307.
Check this out. The 8th grade panoramic picture is tomorrow. All of the 8th graders will have their picture taken during 5th period. Don't forget to look your best tomorrow.
8th graders, you still have one more chance to order your 8th grade t-shirts. All t-shirts are $10 and you must turn in your money by tomorrow to Ms. Lopez in room 300. If you need another order form, see Ms. Lopez. If you're going to the 8th grade class Disneyland trip, you will need to wear your t-shirt.
Oh, thank you for reminding me. Hey, Bridge Builders, you're having a meeting tomorrow at lunch in room 300. Again, there's a Bridge Builder meeting tomorrow at lunch in room 300.
Did you ever get punished so severe that your mom or dad, because of your bad grades? Well, 15-year-old James Mond had an experience that he'll never forget. His mom ordered him to stand on the street while wearing a sign that said, "Honk if I need better education." James' mom, Rhonda Holder, wanted to teach him a lesson for having bad grades. James was forced to stand for 4 hours telling the world about his 1.22 GPA. As you might have guessed, hundreds of people honked in laughter. The Department of Children and Families is investigating whether or not this was a form of child abuse. Rhonda answered that she does not care what the organization says. She did this for the sake of her own son's education.
That's weird.
That's pretty mean.
Well, the parents aren't Asian. Now it's time for your daily dispatch where Araceli Hernandez brings today's top fashion.
Hey children, let's go see more fashion. First, we have Melissa and Alicia Bieber. Melissa is wearing a pink broccoli dress with a white sweater and adds it with black Toms. Alicia is wearing a black and white striped t-shirt to go with her matching shoes with a striped sweater and blue skinnies. Then we have Alexis and Desiree. Alexis wearing the color guard dress on the top, it says Trojans. Desiree is wearing the web shirt with some blue skinnies and adds it with some beige Toms. Last we have Samuel. He is wearing a black tee with some blue skinnies. He adds it with some black bands. Was that some good fashion or what? We'll see you next week.
Yeah, that I look pretty bad in that picture. Taking a look at Tetzloff's calendar, today is the CJSF and International Society meeting at lunch, the TriStar Basketball Contest, and the Ice Cream Sales after school. And tomorrow is a minimum day, College Friday, the 8th grade panoramic photo shoot, bridge builder meeting at Lunchroom 300, and Italian ice sales after school. And that wraps up the ongoing event. Now let's go to Victoria Lee with the weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, Alexis. It's going to be, I think, 84 degrees today. It's going to be really warm. Well, next week it's going to be, clouds are going to come in. Well, it's going to be partly cloudy or mostly sunny. So let's take a look at the map. Denver is the only city that will be windy, while Florida is still going to be stormy, and the East Coast is still going to be rainy. Well, Nevada and California are still going to be a sunny city, and all the way to Texas also. Let's take a look at the Friday forecast. It's going to be sunny today, while tomorrow through Sunday will be partly cloudy, clearing up on Monday where it's going to be mostly sunny. Today's going to be 84 degrees, so yeah, let's bring over Dion with the wet poll.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Dion Thomas. For this week's wet poll, we have Andrew with us. He played on the school's basketball team. Well, good morning, Andrew. How are you?
I'm good. Good morning.
That's good. Well, will you please read this week's wet poll?
Sure. Should Tesla sports be co-ed?
Well, here's what you told us, Trojans. Yes. Yes, it's called equal rights. Another one you guys said, no, some girls might break a nail. Well, we want to hear from you. Be sure to visit us online at live5show.com to vote. Send your comments to webpoll@live5show.com, and if it's good, we'll read it on the air. So, Andrew, what do you think?
I say no, because girls should play with girls and boys should play with boys.
Okay. Well, that's all my time for today, but before I go, I would like to give a shout-out to Alexis Noquez.
And I'd like to give a shout-out to Brandon and Kershen.
Okay, back to you, Jimmy.
Yeah. Really? She needs a shout-out? I don't get it. Okay, well, anyways, it's now time to swing into action with your Live 5 Sports Report with Erin. Good morning, Erin. How you doing?
Good morning, Jimmy. Good. From the North Pole to South Pole and everything in between, this is Live 5 Sports. I'm Erin. Dirk Nowitzki scored 24 points, and the Dallas Mavericks rallied in the fourth quarter to beat the Clippers 106-100 yesterday. They improved their NBA's best road game for their fifth straight win. Yes, wow, they're on a roll. Dirk Nowitzki missed the first of two free throws in the game, snapping his streak of 74 in a row, the longest in the league this season. Well, at least he got the win. And yesterday, our Tetzel Trojans girls basketball team and boys soccer team played against the Whitney Wildcats. Both of our teams won. The girls won 23-19, and the boys, I believe, won by one because of a penalty kick. Great job. Both were terrific games, and the girls even went into overtime. And for all you baseball fans, don't forget today is opening day for the Major Leagues. Well, before I go, shout out to Alyssa Mochan, 11 points. That's good. Back to you, Jimmy.
11 points, that's good. Thank you, Erin. It's time to test your knowledge today, Zilly, for 1-1.
Who invented the electric car? A doctor, a dentist, an engineer, or an electrician? Take five.
I bet it's a dentist.
I think a doctor.
I was just saying, oh my goodness, the electrician needs a shout out. But then I was like, yeah.
Oh, I got it right. Hey, you're just mad dentist. You didn't get the shout out, okay?
Can you give me a shout out right now?
Shout out to Jimmy Zhang.
Tang.
I don't know what you're having to pronounce
Tang,
your last name.
Not Tang, not
Zhang.
Zhang. Okay, and Michelle Mignon. Okay.
Oh yeah, Michelle Mignon.
My mom's a dentist.
Okay, visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at liveofficial.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
That's the end of today's show. We'll see you back here tomorrow morning.
You tell me that you need me, but then you wanna leave me and never make your way to the door. Too much, and then I miss you too much. Don't leave it.